Welcome to all the spiritual refugees who are streaming in here, finding refuge from the storms that are taking place now. The advantage here is that I knew all of this would come about way ahead of time, 50, 55 years ago. I came in with the knowledge of the future and what would happen, so I've been able to prepare for it ahead of time and be of service at this time. And the main focus here is to free you from the blame game, because that is the trap that has been set. Existence is always setting that trap. Not only does it build constructivity up in order to destroy it, but it then also asks you to try and assess blame for the destruction. And this is called judgment. Exercising judgment. This is the key, the very key to your situation, to the trap, is to avoid the blame game, avoid judgment. Instead, turn to forgiveness. The central teaching in this world, the highest spiritual teaching, is forgiveness. There's a practical purpose for that, because it enables you to avoid this trap. Because as you try to find blame for these troubles, for the collapse of civilization, you get enmeshed in it. You continue your fixation on it. You try to figure it out. Your attention is entirely absorbed by existence, and you try and trace everything and say, well, this one did that, and that did that, and these bad guys over here, who are the bad guys, who are the good guys? And it's so unbelievably complex that you find yourself completely engaged and fixated on it, which is exactly what existence wants. But real salvation is to forgive, and instead of blaming the players, blame the game. Meaning, instead of blaming the effects, the dynamic at play, the dynamic that is dancing, blame the idea that causes the dynamic to dance. That is the key. It's a bad idea. Spirit chose a bad idea. It's not God that is responsible for existence. It's Spirit. Spirit is the one that chose the idea that is giving rise to existence. That's a very important fact. So as you come here and you listen to this, you're going to be cooling down from the blame game. You're going to be disinvesting in that. You're going to be turning over toward forgiveness. Not a personal forgiveness, a blanket forgiveness. Forgive the entire play of existence, because it's not doing anything to reality. Reality is entirely untouched by dreams of its demise. But do blame the idea. It's a bad idea. We are spirit, and we chose a bad idea. The idea of trying to replace reality with a new reality is a bad idea. It's a terrible idea. It's a weird, strange, tiny, mad idea. And to expect the dynamic effects that arise from this to be satisfactory to us is quite contrary to what happens. So we're getting what you would expect to get in existence, which is the constant dance of constructivity and destructivity. But now if you turn towards blaming just the idea, then what is the remedy? Choose a new idea. Very simple. You see how that simplifies your destiny to an ultimate extent. Frees you from all entanglements of judgment, because you're only judging one thing, and that is the idea. And you're judging that you don't like it. You want to choose a new idea. That is how simple it really is. It's ultimate in simplicity and clarity. We call it Christ clarity. That's the clarity of Christ. Christ within you, which is really referring to your spirit. Spirit within you knows all of this. But has gotten so fixated on this one idea to the exclusion of all other ideas that it's forgotten its functionality. It's forgotten what it is. And so it needs to remind itself, which it does, which it can do, and is doing. Now the world is going to be caught up in massive retributions and blame. You can already feel it everywhere, can't you? Throughout the world, there's so much war and violence and conflict taking place now. It's raging like wildfires everywhere. What is that all about? It's about people blaming each other, isn't it? You're bad. You're wicked. We want to get rid of you. But just think, if people really hear the truth, they'll say, let's not blame each other for anything. Let's just realize it's the idea that is causing all this madness. Is it right for the puppeteer to blame the puppets for the puppet dance? The marionettes for their gyrations? Is that right? Is that sane? Imagine if you're the puppeteer and you have all these puppets and you're moving them around and they're hitting each other with sticks and back and forth and they're fighting. Do you blame the puppets for that? Or do you blame the puppeteer? The idea is the puppeteer. The people are just puppets. So why blame the puppets for what the puppeteer is doing? It's the idea that is doing all of this, that's driving all of this. Effects aren't separate from the idea. Cause and effect are not separate from one another. They're two sides of one coin. This is Christ's clarity. This is the clarity of Christ. This is what preparation is all about for these times. That's what it's been about. Being able to see this. The simple truth as conflagration rages in this world. And it's just beginning. Wait until the full unraveling takes place of the economy, of Wall Street, the world financial system, the economic system. Everybody's going to be at each other's throats. But you who have found this refuge realize, no, that's not for me. That's not for me. That's not my destiny. My destiny is Christ's clarity and to choose a new idea and to experience the incredible seamlessness of that with no disturbance whatsoever from this other idea that you've set down. Once you set this idea down, it's not going to disturb you anymore. Cannot. Ideas don't have power over other ideas. Each one is a God unto itself, as it were, a power unto itself, a cause unto itself. You can't take one idea and affect other ideas with it. Not in reality, you cannot. You can only do so plausibly, by symbolic, through symbology. But that's not reality, it's not actuality. So welcome here to this channel, Christ Clarity, which has a very practical effectiveness for you if you can recognize the opportunity, recognize the temptation you have to get sucked into the blame game and how that's going to inflame you, and you're going to be set on flame by that, figuratively and maybe later on literally, because this world is heading toward conflagration. At least that's some destiny pass. Those who play the blame game are really going to get a severe dose of that. But those who play the forgiveness game, they're going to get a wonderful benefit from that. So let's turn our attention toward forgiveness here in our time together. Okay, very good. Very good. Thank you. And that's it.